When we think of serial killers, we generally think of men. According to the Journal of Forensic Psychiatry and Psychology, only 16% of serial killers are women. However, there is a long history of female serial killers, and statistics show women are more likely to kill for material gain than pleasure, and their methods are generally more covert. As the following examples will show, not only are women just as deadly as men, they are often more intelligent and creative in their deadly intentions. Before we begin today's story, please take a moment to click like and subscribe to our channel. Number 1, Elizabeth Bathory Dirext. Known as the Blood Countess, Elizabeth Bathory Dirext was a noblewoman in the Kingdom of Hungary. She was married to Count Nadasdy and managed his estates while he was at war, as well as after his death in 1604. Despite a reputation for helping destitute women, a local Lutheran priest implicated her in the disappearance of several local girls in 1609, and decades of murder were revealed. Alongside four companions, Bathory had lured peasant girls and lesser ladies with a promise of work or etiquette lessons. On arrival, they were beaten, burned, frozen, and starved to death. The countess was sentenced to solitary confinement, though she only lived 5 years in walled-up rooms in her home, Ksetch Castle. Stories spread that she'd bathed in her victims' blood to maintain her beauty, however, there is no real evidence of this. Number 2. Lavinia Fisher. Lavinia Fisher and her husband John were gang members in Charleston, South Carolina, where they ran the 6 Mile Wayfarer House. They welcomed lone travelers into their hotel, where they then questioned, drugged, and robbed them. Depending on the account, they stabbed the men to death, or dropped them into pits beneath collapsing beds. Eventually, a vigilante gang spurred local authorities to act, and the couple was tried, convicted, and hanged for their crimes. As the USA's first female serial killer, Lavinia was said to have crushed men's heads with her legs and shouted at her execution, "If any of you have a message for the devil, tell me now, for I shall be seeing him shortly." Number 3. Amelia Dyer. Amelia Dyer was born in England in 1838 and trained as a nurse, before becoming a baby farmer for abandoned infants. By allowing the infants in her care to die of starvation, Dyer was able to boost her income, but the suspiciously high number of deaths led to charges and time served for neglect. She soon returned to baby farming, though her crimes were eventually unearthed in the finding of several hundred infants' remains. The Reading Baby Farmer, as she was known, is thus one of history's most prolific serial killers, though Dyer was tried and hanged in 1896 for only one proven murder. Number 4. Maria Swanenburg. Maria Swanenburg was a Dutch mother of seven, who was known by the nickname Goodmie, due to the care she provided to the sick in her poor neighborhood. However, between 1880 and 1883, she was responsible for an outbreak of arsenic poisoning. Authorities eventually caught Maria Swanenburg attempting to poison a local family. She had apparently started by poisoning her own parents, before attempting to kill at least 102 people over a period of several years. Swanenburg was jailed for life in 1885 for the deaths of 27 people and the suffering of 45 others, who survived, but lived their lives with health complications. Number 5. Jane Toppan. Jane Toppan was a Boston nurse who tested opiates on and killed patients before being dismissed for recklessness. As a private nurse, she killed several people, including her landlord's foster sister and elderly patient Alden Davis, whose wife and daughters she also poisoned. Toppan then courted and poisoned her late sister's husband and killed his sister. In 1901, her crimes were revealed when the family of Alden Davis ordered toxicology reports, and she confessed to 31 murders. During her trial, she described the thrill of holding people as they died and said she'd hoped to kill more people than any other man or woman who ever lived. Toppan was found not guilty due to insanity, and Jolly Jane, as she was called, died in Taunton Insane Hospital. Number 6. Belle Gunness. Belle Gunness left Norway for the USA, where she met and married Mads Sorensen. Shortly after they wed, the couple opened a confectionery in Chicago. They collected insurance from two children's deaths and from the shop when it burned down. After Mads died, Bell used his insurance to buy a farm in LaPorte, Indiana, and eventually married Peter Gundus, who also soon died. She then lured suitors with newspaper ads, though each man disappeared, leaving their valuables behind. In 1908, after threats from her former farmhand, her home went up in flames with her children inside. The farmhand confessed to helping Gunness escape and burying her victims, of which around 40, were found in her pigsty. Neither Bell, nor the $250,000 she withdrew the week before the fire, was ever found. Number 7. Dagmar Overby. Dagmar Overby was a caretaker for children born out of wedlock in Copenhagen. From 1913 to 1920, she strangled, drowned, or burned around 25 children. Overby's crimes were discovered when she took on Caroline Argeson's daughter in 1920, and Argeson asked Overby to return the child, to which Overby refused. Police searched the caretaker's Vesterbro district apartment and discovered the girl's bones in the heater, along with other children's remains. The Vesterbro baby burner, as she was called, was sentenced to death, but given life in prison, though her gruesome actions led to significant Danish childcare legislation. Number 8. Leonarda Ciancioli. Leonarda Ciancioli was a housewife, fortune teller, and shopkeeper in Correggio, Italy, who hoped to use human sacrifice to protect her son while he was in the army. She told three middle-aged neighbors of opportunities, the first, Faustina Setti, of a suitor, and latter two, Francesca Sovi and Virginia Casiopo, of jobs. Each sent postcards to friends and family before Ciancioli murdered them. She tossed the flesh into a septic tank and used the blood for tea cakes, though the third's sweetness prompted her to make soap from her flesh. Ciancioli confessed when Casiopo's sister-in-law called authorities, and, in 1946, the soap maker of Correggio was sentenced to 30 years in prison, where she died. Number 9. Miyuki Ishikawa. As the director of Tokyo's Kotobuki Maternity Hospital in the 1940s, Ishikawa cared for infants whose parents could not afford them. Her solution was to let them die from neglect. With the help of her husband and a doctor who falsified death certificates, Ishikawa was responsible for the death of around 100 children and attempted to charge parents for the service. When officers stumbled upon remains in 1948, the Ishikawas were arrested, but only sentenced to 4 years in prison. Later, the demon midwife's crimes led to legalization of abortion for economic reasons in Japan. Number 10. Nanny Doss. Known as the Lonely Hearts Killer for finding men on Lonely Hearts Club pages, Nancy Hazel married her first husband, Charlie Braggs, in 1921, though they parted ways after the death of two children. Nanny then married Robert Harrelson in 1929, but, in 1945, she put rat poison in his whiskey after he raped her, killing him. Her next three husbands, Ali Lanning of North Carolina, Richard L. Morton of Kansas, and Samuel Doss of Oklahoma, perished under similar circumstances. In 1954, Nanny was arrested for Doss's murder and confessed to killing her four husbands, two children, two sisters, mother, grandson, and mother-in-law. She said she had been searching for the perfect mate, but never found him. She eventually died alone, in prison. Number 11. Aileen Wuornos. Aileen Wuornos' mother left her and her brother with their grandparents, but her grandfather molested her, and she became pregnant with his child when she was 14. She dropped out of school, was kicked out of her home, and fell into a life of crime that led her to Florida. There, she fell in love and moved in with Tyria Moore, supporting them both through sex work. In 1989, she was raped by a Richard Mallory, whom she shot to death. In the next year, Wuornos killed six other men, including a retired U.S. Air Force major. After being caught in a victim's car, she claimed self-defense, but later admitted guilt to get off death row. She was executed in 2002, and her life of crime inspired the film Monster. Number 12. Juana Barraza. Juana Barraza's father sold sex with his daughter Fabia when she was a child. Yet, it was her resentment for her mother that led to the strangling or bludgeoning of 11 elderly women. Although she had a career as professional wrestler La Dama del Silencio, Barraza claimed she murdered the women to help society. Police initially believed the murderer to be a transvestite, but Barraza was caught fleeing a victim's house in 2006, after posing as a welfare official to gain the woman's trust. Evidence linked her to at least 10 murders, and Barraza was sentenced to 759 years in prison. Number 13. Dorothea Puente. Puente purchased the now infamous 16-bedroom care home in Sacramento in 1968 and began handling residents' mail and money. Before that, she'd gone through several marriages and charges for forging checks, operating a brothel, vagrancy, and fraud. Her first murder was roommate Ruth Monroe, who overdosed in 1982. After serving 3 years for theft, she befriended and lived with Everson Gilmouth until his remains turned up in a box Puente had built for storage. When a tenant went missing in 1988, police investigated and found 7 bodies buried in the yard. Although Puente claimed they'd all died naturally, she most likely dosed each with sleeping pills before suffocating and burying them in the yard. Puente herself died in prison at the age of 82. What did you think of this story? Thanks for watching, and again, please click like and subscribe to my channel.